Hello everyone and welcome to Fuel the Adrenaline Outdoors. So, I was just going through and editing this video, realized that I had not done an intro for it. The video is from late October when the Pennsylvania coon trapping season had just come in. We are rolling on our first traps and we have a double. So, I hope you guys enjoy and we're going to jump right into this first clip. If you guys like, please comment, subscribe, and like the video. If you want to know what goes on and you want to be the first to know, follow our Instagram. The posts are always up on Instagram before the videos are going to be up. So, hope you guys enjoy.
What's up, buddy?
All right, so bear with me, guys. I am trying to set this and videotape it on my phone. I didn't bring my big camera today. I got a lot of schoolwork to get done. Didn't really plan on making a video, but since we caught a double right here next to each other, I'm gonna do a quick little video. Here's our coon over there. Here's our spot. He's got it real tore up here. That doesn't matter. Now, I bait this with cat food. Just using our dog proof here. This is a ztrap. And I stick that so that way the springs are out of the way. And they don't get caught in the ground. I've never had it happen, but I like to set them just on the side on the side of caution. But so I just use cat food. This year I'm trying something a little different. I am using some cherry flavor bait. PA guy makes this, so. It smells really good. It's a strong smell of cherry. The coons seem to have liked it. I've caught all three coons in the past few days on this jar. But so what I do is I find a little stick. I'm not shy with my bait or lure. I'd rather use more and catch more. I just smear some on the trap, some on the tree there. Then I also take a little bit and I get it up high here in these branches. It's that way the wind carries it. And I just get rid of the stick over there. There's a little stream right there. I just threw in the stream. And then in my backpack here, I have, it's just in one of these bottles, but in here is vanilla flavoring. And I'm just gonna spray some in there, spray it on the tree there, and that's it. So, we're gonna go over, we're gonna dispatch the other one, and we'll get back to you guys on that one. Maybe I'll show a video of this dispatch in this next one. It's not a real big coon. This was the biggest that we've caught so far this year, but second day, we're up to three. Stay tuned, guys. Here we go, guys. Coon number two. Now, one thing that I'd like to mention with this stick here. He's caught good, so we don't have to worry about it. One thing I want to mention is I want to show you guys where I shoot them. Especially if you're selling the hides, fur buyers like to take off money for any extra holes. And obviously shooting them is the easiest way and the most humane way to dispatch them, in my opinion. It's quick, it's easy, it's taken care of. But if you shoot them through the head between the eyes, and aim that bullet so it goes through the body, it doesn't blow up and it doesn't come out. So I'll show you guys what I mean with the edge of the stick here. Now, here's the stick. If you get down, you can see his head and then the full body. If you put that bullet right there, it's gonna go through his body and it won't come out. So, just a little tip there. to try to get the most amount of money out of your pelts. Hello everyone, welcome back to Fuel the Adrenaline Outdoors. Yet again today, I'm videotaping on my cell phone, so bear with me. I don't have a tripod at the moment for my camera, mine broke. So this is the third trap of the day we checked. It is October 30th, it's a Wednesday, third day of the season, third day of checking it anyway, and we have a coon in our third trap. So I'll show you guys, it's not a real big coon, but he's got a nice trapping circle. We just reset it, so I'll let you guys see what it looks like. There's our coon here, not too bad, not huge, but we'll take him. So cat food down there, we got a little bit of the cherry paste. We're using cherry paste again. Some cat food on the ground. We have cherry paste on the tree, and we have some vanilla I squirted on there. Also, what I do, I don't know if you guys can see it there, in that tree there and on the limbs, there is a little bit of that cherry paste. I like to get that cherry paste. It has quite the smell to it. I like to get it up in the tree, and the wind blows it around, and I think it attracts them to my spot. So, just another little tip for you guys, day three. Hope you guys are enjoying. We're gonna check the other ones and we'll get back to you if we have any more. Just wanted to catch you guys up here with a little outro. I did not film everything from that week since it would kind of get boring for you guys, since we run all of our coon traps the exact same way with the cherry paste and the cat food in the bottom. The cherry paste is something new we're trying this year. It's working phenomenal for us. We caught 9 coons in a week, which was great. We never do that well. But I did have to pull my traps after that week of trapping just because it got busy with finals and stuff at school. So I am out now. It is December 22nd. The video will be up today. And I do hope to get some traps out tomorrow for Fisher. Fisher came in today. So tomorrow, or yesterday. Fisher came in yesterday. But I will get some traps out and hopefully we can catch some Fisher. So there will be videos on that, and there will be some flintlock videos coming up, dialing them in, hunting, stuff like that, because the Pennsylvania season is coming up the day after Christmas. So possibly tomorrow, we got a lot going on. So you guys stay tuned for next week, and hope you enjoyed.